Welcome to Speedcast Starlink series. In this series, we're going to take a Starlink terminal and look how it performs in a terrestrial environment. We did the marine applications and we have a lot of great information on the water. Now we want to see how Starlink performs when we put it on a vehicle and we drive it around. Got a lot of customers asking about how it performs when you go under tree coverage or how it works in different areas or in more densely covered areas. We didn't show it in the marine video, but a very important aspect for that video was how to power the Starlink terminal. Boats run on 12 volts, so do cars. So we used an inverter to convert the 12 volts into 110 volts for this Starlink panel. A very important fact that I want everyone to know for this is you need to make sure you have a full wave inverter to be able to convert your 12 volt to 110 that Starlink or an electronics device can use. Starlink doesn't allow you to change anything about its structure. The panels have to be outside, they can't be in a dome. You can't cut the cables and change the cables. It changes the performance of the system, which could ultimately affect everybody using the service. So you have to be able to use the stuff that they give you the way they give you. So these cables, this 8-meter cable, has proven to be a challenge for a lot of installations because 8 meters just isn't long enough for many applications. So a lot of companies and people are using a utilities enclosure like this, which we're going to use on this demo. This is an IP66 rated, which means it's waterproof. You can get these things wet. These devices are also outdoor rated, but it's better to be able to have them close and contained in one thing, as well as the power outlets, right? Because these power outlets aren't waterproof rated like these ones are as well. So being able to get it all into a sealed enclosure, some nice cable seals here at the bottom, we protect these devices from the elements, they don't get dirty, you have a nice robust way. The last thing is how we're going to install the panel onto the vehicle. Now there's things you can do like magnets. Magnets, a strong magnet that would hold a vehicle, not good near sensitive electronic devices, so we really don't recommend it. There's other things like suction cups to be able to put it to the roof. But again, I don't know that I trust a suction cup with this particular deployment, so I'm going to go for a nice, good physical install. We're going to use this great aluminum mount from Seaview. They sell a number of these in different sizes, different ways. We have some different kits that will work with. But we've created a little platform to be able to go over the truck bed and mount the Starlink just above the truck so you don't have any of the blockage challenges with the panel. Starlink certifies these panels, or they want the panels to have 140 degrees of clear view of the sky. So by mounting it above the truck and at an angle, the wind will keep the panel down, we're not going to risk losing it, and we're going to get our best chance of having good clear visibility beyond trees. So let's get this installed, let's see how it does. Okay, you now have the Starlink installed on the truck. So I've built the frame that the pedestal is sitting on, and this antenna has a good view of the sky. I wanted to show this. This is kind of important. Whenever you're looking for the inverter, it's always difficult to find the right size. So you can see that right now we're running at 13.4 volts and about 180 watts. So these systems use more than 180 watts in some cases when you're doing the snow ice melt. So you need something that's going to have a little bit more. Plus there is a surge current whenever you first start it up. So you want to be a little bit bigger than 180 watts. This one's 1,000 watts, but we're going to be fine for this testing. So let's get on. Let's see how the testing does. All right, we're driving with Starlink testing. I've got my laptop here. We'll add this video over the top of the laptop so you can see it. But we're driving, very little trees, partly cloudy skies, good visibility. Starlink is performing pretty well, good speed so far, but we're definitely outside of the city. We want to see how it does. So we'll keep going, let's keep showing these results. Okay, we're going down this road. You can see some overhangs here, but we're seeing a lot more packet loss, a lot less network stability. So we're going to keep an eye on it, but it's not doing great in this tight environment or with these trees or overhangs. Okay, we've transitioned to a dirt road, and it's very bumpy and probably noisy, but you can see the trees have cleared up, and the internet seems to be cleared up. We're still seeing some packet loss from time to time. All right, it started to rain on us here for this the Starlink trial, so I just wanted to get a video of the level of rain. This is really not much. This is kind of a light drizzle. You'd stop the truck and just so we could see, so it's not while we're moving at speed, the rain levels. All right, we have stopped and we're seeing a whole lot of packet loss. We can see it's really affected by this. So. Okay, we're driving in the rain again. I'm not driving, I'm riding. but it's raining pretty hard. We're still seeing 30 by 10 and a half on this Starlink speed test just now. Very little packet loss. Really quite impressed with the amount of rain fade avoidance it has on it, as well as still moving at speed. So some other effects there. So pretty interesting to see. Okay, we're coming up on an overpass. So I just want to capture this so you guys can see performance as she goes down the interstate and on an overpass. And we go under. And this is the packet loss from the overpass. And you can see we're right back online and we can do our speed test again. Okay, we've done our Starlink testing for today. Had a couple of good key takeaways from it. We got to test it while it was moving, anywhere from standing still up to about 70, 75 miles an hour. It did great. Under movement, it did great. We got to test it in the rain, not in the rain. It did very well in the rain, much better than I expected it to do while we were moving at the same time. So I hope you liked that part of the video as well. Interesting to see too on the latency. We could see latency running pretty normal, and then we would see a spike, and then we would see it normal again. It looked like where it was changing satellites, so pretty neat observation. I think the biggest takeaway for me was the amount of obstruction that the satellite was susceptible to while you're driving around. So just like when you put it on your house, so you put it in a fixed application, it's very sensitive to not being able to see the sky. So where you had constricted areas, certainly we lost a lot of packet loss, we lost a lot of connectivity through that part of it. But otherwise it did very well. We've tried it in a number of different ways. I hope you liked the video. Remember to like it if you did. And come see us for the next one. Thank you.